Assalamualaikum dear students, welcome to all of you in our new lecture, lecture 50. My dear students, I am your teacher Adnan Adam and this is class first year. Dear students, in previous lecture we explained the criteria, different criteria on the basis of which we can classify the animals, and different criteria we discussed like tissue organization, and number of the germ layer, presence of coelom, symmetry, and then the deuterostome, protostome along with that. So different criteria we studied on the basis of which we can classify the animals. Now we are starting today the next lecture, that is invertebrates. Invertebrates are those are animals which lack the vertebral column. Then animals are called invertebrates. Usually 95% of the total animals belong to this group. Only 5% of the animals, especially now, are vertebrates. 95% are invertebrates. In invertebrates, we have different phyla. So the first phylum is phylum Porifera. Usually they are generally called sponges. They are probably the most simple eukaryotic multicellular organisms on the earth, animals on the earth. Finally, Porifera general characteristics, if we talk about its general characteristics. So in general characteristics, first is the habitat where it's living. The first is habitat. So by habitat, they all are aquatic. In aquatic, there are two types of aquatic animals or environment we have. One is called marine environment and one is called fresh water environment. You need to keep in mind that both have different biology. Freshwater. It's few of species are freshwater, marine now. Majority are marine. Number two, they are seaside. To some solid substratum, but the larvae are motile. Adults are okay. They are parasitic and usually now. Tissue organization is present. If we talk about its general body surface,
this. Outer dermal layer is called pinacoderm. And the second layer it have is called choanoderm, which consists of many small cells, flagellated, which are called collar cells. This, it have a lot single opening called osculum. Along with their body have many small pores, and these small pores are called ostia. This is a collar cell. It's budding, to budding gradually. It is reduced, and by sexual nothing. Usually, now we can use foundation. It may be unisexual. Unisexual means sexes are separate. Hermaphrodite means that organism who is bisexual, who have both male and female reproductive organ. This is phenomenon is called hermaphroditism. So some hermaphrodite species will ask. We give an example. We come to the last example. This example usually having cycomb is very powerful spongula. So my dear students, it was all about phylum Porifera. Now we will move towards phylum Malaria. And if we talk about the importance of this phylum, so skeleton of sponges are used for washing and bathing. Sponges have great capacity to absorb water. They are used in surgical operations for absorbing fluids and blood.
commercially they are very important sponges. Next is file ingredient. It was previously called celebrates. First we will talk about its habitat. Symmetry radial. They are diploblastic, mesubrial layer is present in blastic. This is called denticle. They have single gastrovascular cavity. Along with that, they have single opening which serve both as a mouth and anus. Single opening. Act as a mouth and anus both. They have a unique kind of defense mechanism that have called nematocyst. This is a unique one. Flask-shaped cells, and they usually secrete
their structures, and they usually immobilizing the pre in the pre immobilize the tentacle. Just pick them and bring them to the mouth. And another unique characteristic is the termination of generation. Nubidia, which is a member of the Nubidian group, this body is called polyp. The existence of morphologically different organisms in same colony. They're usually called zooids. So this is our termination of generation. If we talk about this example, jellyfish belongs to this phylum. So when you students are talking about phylum Nidalia, then I went towards the, if you talk about the importance of coral reefs are usually found by the Nidalians. And they are very important, specifically to have found a habitat for marine organisms. Along with that, corals are used in jewelry and other used in aquaria, rock gardens, etc. Some anemia have poisonous stings, like jellyfish and sea anemone. They have sometimes. Can be dangerous. The next one is phylum Platyhelminthes. So let's discuss phylum Platyhelminthes general characteristics.
Next is phylum, Plantae Helminthes. Flare forms. First, root is heavy root. Most of them are parasitic and they are living inside the host body. And along with that, they are free living also. Some free living species are also present. Excretory organs they have. Called flame cells. This is the cilia, and these cilia usually flickering like candle, that's why they are called flame cells. The digestive system is incomplete. Pair of ganglia they have, and then they have nerve cards. The reproduction may be by asexual, by fragmentation of body. Should divide. each part will develop into a new plant area. Okay, the sexual reproduction, usually well developed reproductive systems are well developed. Example, tapeworm, planarian, liver fluke. These are the examples of the phylum Escherichia. Next will be phylum Escherichia, mollusks, annelids, arthropods, and echinoderms. I think that's enough for today. Inshallah, in our coming lecture, we will explain the next phylums which are coming. Stay in home, stay blessed, Allah Hafiz.